Let's play. What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 11 of the Ultimate Let's Play Final Fantasy VI. As you see, I've done a little bit of level grinding off camera, and I've switched my party members around. Now I have Locke, Cyan, Sabin, and Celis with me. Locke did level up once, the other three leveled up twice. And Sabin finally learned Fire Dance, and Cyan learned Quadra Slam, as I'm demonstrating right now. Quadra Slam is basically a quadruple attack. Hits four random targets, and this is a fire-based attack that hits all enemies. And that is the Fire Dance from Sabin. So those are definitely going to come in handy when I go through this next town, Zozo. Also, during my grinding, Shadow apparently left the party when I went to Narsh to switch my party members. He just plain up and left, so I don't have Shadow with me anymore. So that's kind of unfortunate, but here we are now in Zozo. This town is kind of unique in that I can get attacked virtually at any point. And right away, I'm a little bit scared of that Hades Gigas here. It has an attack called Magnitude 8. If I get hit with that, I'm pretty much dead. And also, as you can see, I did a little something with Locke off camera as well. I gave him the Genji Glove, and I bought another Full Moon. So now he can attack twice with pretty powerful attacks every turn. So that's definitely going to come in handy. So now Locke can become an offensive powerhouse here. I'm going to go ahead and demo Quadra Slam real quick. This will normally hit random targets. Otherwise, it'll hit one target four times. Now I'm probably getting a lot of experience and a lot of gold here. Not to mention, this town is a very catchy tune. Clock's second hand's pointing at 30. Well, that's actually a clue to a puzzle later on, where you have to set a clock. Kind of gotta listen to a lot of people in the town about what they say about that clock, and they'll open the door to a couple of treasures. I've done this place so many times, a lot of takes off camera, so I actually know the answer by heart. Just gonna show off the area a little bit here while I'm doing this. I'm getting these preemptive attacks now. I really gotta keep an eye on my HP and my MP because I'm not gonna be seeing a save point for a while, and I got a tough boss at the end of this place. These guys are relentless. I'm actually getting a bit of a good draw. I'm only getting one enemy at a time. Uh-oh, but here comes fire too. This is gonna hurt. Yeah, just Oko Locke there. Luckily, I got a few Phoenix Downs. Got eight of them. Probably burned through quite a few of them. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate Fire Dance. This is better used against multiple enemies. But it's for me, it's left, left, down, down, right. And let us be do Fire Dance. I need to heal up Locke here. Edgar and Gal are still at their respective levels. They may level up next time I see them. I believe Shadow was at like level 13 or so when he left the party. Really, he... As soon as I went back to Narsh and decided to switch party members, that's when he left. So I guess you can't take Shadow into Narsh for whatever reason. Alright, well, here's the relic shop. I don't know if I can buy anything here. I guess not. It's still a very catchy tune. I think Nobuo Uematsu did a great job with this tune. Definitely captures the essence of the area. Yeah, I'm not gonna fight this guy. If I get a preemptive strike, I'm gonna try and run. Just because I'm trying to conserve power. I think I've done enough level grinding off camera. So here's where I can reset the clock. Now I believe the answer that we came up with was 6, 10, 50, I believe. Okay. If you talk to a lot of people in town, they'll kind of clue you in on what the answer is. And we got a chainsaw. That's a tool for Edgar. Very powerful single-target attack with a potential for a one-hit knockout. So once I get Edgar back on the team, that could come in handy. Unfortunately, it doesn't work too well with bosses. This is a perfect opportunity to really show off Fire Dance. Go ahead and use Quadra Slam as well. So one thing I don't like about the Sortex is that you gotta wait a while to charge them up. But the Quadra Slam did the trick there. And Locke finally has leveled up, so now everybody on my team is level 15. A little bit of trouble finding the stairs there. Okay. Now where to go from here? This is definitely the trickiest area of the game in my opinion. Especially early on. But I believe this is where we're gonna find Terra. It's actually a good combination here. Have Saban use Fire Dance and use the animation time to build up the Sword Tech for Cyan. Which these guys have potions so they can heal themselves. And we got two of them. I tell you, I'm really liking that Genji glove right now. I'm glad I took the time to get it a couple episodes back. I didn't think it worked that well with Locke there. So this guy's giving us a little bit of a hint to not jump in between buildings, which is going to be kind of a key for us getting through this area. It looks like we're going to have to fight this Haze guy who's here. I just gotta hope he doesn't hit magnitude 8. Just gonna stick with basic single target attacks here. This does quite a bit of damage here. 130, 260, 400, about 530, which was enough there. I think I have to climb to the top of this building. I wonder if I just used Fire Dance at the beginning of the battle, that may have gone a little bit quicker. Alright, let's start working our way up. Now on the outside of the building, going back in. Guess we're just going to follow these guys through the building. Take out this Slam Dancer. Level 2 attack here. And I'm going to have to burn another Phoenix down. Fortunately, Celestine really get that runic off in time. And unfortunately, because of that, Locke's gonna miss out on the experience there. So, them's the breaks, I guess. Let's burn another Phoenix down. I'm down to 6 now. I know I still got quite a bit of magic, but I wanna go ahead and burn through my tonics first before I resort to using Cure here. Again, these guys We're also guys that give you hints regarding the clock. This one guy might as well kill him. This should be enough. There you go. Unfortunately, I just cannot run past these guys. Alright. Let's see what ice does. See, those earrings are definitely helping out. But this is one of the reasons why I wanted to get Fire Dance before I came into Zozo, so I can do stuff like that. Okay, moving on. Nothing here, but I can jump to another building. Is this where I want to go? I want to check one more thing before I head over there. I think that will take me further into the area. But I think I want to check the top of this building first and see what I can find. Because I know there's a good treasure I can find here. Got the Thief Glove Relic. So I'm going to give this to Locke. What this will do is change steal into capture. So now with that command, I can steal and attack on the same turn. Definitely keep the full moons on. See, this is definitely going to be helpful here. You don't keep those relics in Cyan there. I think there's one more door. I cannot go there, so I'll have to just move on. So now I'm going to go ahead and start jumping across here. Sorry, I had to adjust my mic there. For a second, I thought that guy attacked me, but... Ah, jeez. That was a multi-attack, so it didn't kill anybody. I'm actually kind of glad I did that instead of just focusing it all on one target. Again, more hints regarding the clock. Now, I could have just gone around and started asking around about how to solve that puzzle, but the truth is, with all these enemies around, I just wanted to study it all off camera and just write down what the end result was. And Saban just died. And we stole a potion. Oh, that's nifty. So apparently with the Thief Glove, I can actually try and steal twice. So I have double the chance of successfully stealing an item. That's very good. That could definitely come in handy, especially if I'm fighting bosses. So I know sometimes those guys will drop rare items. Or I should say you have to steal them, but some bosses do have that. We got a tincture. It's always good to have, especially when you can get it for free. But yeah, I'm really liking the Thief Glove right now. I'm glad I brought Locke here. I mean, Edgar probably would have done pretty good offensively, but I'm kind of glad, now that I have the Thief Glove, I'm glad I have Locke. And plus, he's also one of my favorite characters. Couldn't steal the first time, let's try it again. Got a potion out of it, okay. Good enough. and the more potions I can get, the better off I'll be. This guy's just delaying the inevitable right now. And we got another pair of goggles. And Celis leveled up, and we got another relic, a barrier ring. I think we got at least one of those already. Another hint for the clock. And I'm just going to go ahead and start hopping over here. Alright, so this is where I couldn't get to earlier. I think I'm going to have to go into that door. Not going to bother with the gobbledygax. Again, just trying to conserve some power here. I'm getting kind of close to the boss, so definitely want to keep as much power as possible. So I ascend this very long staircase. I actually thought I was actually going to get through that whole thing without a random encounter. Well, two chances, but couldn't steal. Can't win them all. We got another barrier ring, and Cyan leveled up. So both now Cyan and Celis are both at level 16. Yeah, I really don't want Saban to go berserk, so I'll keep that one ring on him. And we continue our climb up this very tall building. I take one step, and I'm attacked. I love that fire dance. We stole an eye drop. Well, that'll cure darkness. To tell you the truth, I don't think we really need to worry about that, because I think these special abilities are kind of guaranteed to hit. Most of them, I think. Definitely gonna have a lot of gold by the end of this area, and I think I see the boss up there. And I got a fire knuckle that's gonna be a weapon for Saban. That's gonna really jack up his power, but I think it also makes him fire elemental. So if I go across any fire type enemies, may not be the best weapon to have. Alright. Let's go ahead and heal up. Actually, almost out of tonics now. I think I can go in the door first. Well, first I'm going to have to battle some enemies before I can even check the door. I'm actually surprised Celis hasn't used up that much magic power. I'll tell you, I've made a pretty formidable offensive front here with Locke, Cyan, and Saban. Oh, you jerk! You just stole 4,000 of my gold! I hope I get that back after this battle. Well, I guess I did. And Saban got a level up. We gotta fight Denaluma now. I think this guy could really hurt us. We gotta take this guy out quickly. I think the longer animation can also help us out with building the Sortex. We actually just stole a jewel ring. I'll try Aura Bolt instead of Fire Dance, because I think that is non-elemental. Quadra Slam as well. I stole a jewel ring. I wonder if I can steal anything else. See how effective ice is. Not bad. Looks like we can't steal anything else. That's all he had. He just summoned some backup here. I should really just focus on Dataluma though. trying to draw attention away from himself. Hey, we got him. Well, that was a lot easier than I thought it was going to be. I know he had some pretty devastating attacks, but again, you hit him hard, hit him fast, and he's no problem. We got a thief knife, although I'm probably not going to give that to anybody. And we made it to the top. And hey, it's Terra. In her morphed form. Terra? Terra. She's scared, you know. Who are you? This girl is your friend? Is Terra all right? You call her Terra. Terra, how odd. She's undamaged. I fear she can't understand you. As for me, I am Ramu, the Esper Ramu. Esper? But don't Espers live in another world? That doesn't mean we don't live here too. Espers take a variety of forms. Sometimes we live here, taking the shape of humans. You have nothing to fear from us. Why do you hide the fact that you're Espers? Humans and Espers can't survive together. But my grandma told me that Espers and people once lived side by side. Was that just a fairy tale? No, that was no fairy tale. That was true. We started out as friends. Then along came the War of the Magi. Who are the Magi? It took place long ago. Espers fought humans who were infused with magical power extracted from Espers. Fearing our magical powers would once again become a target, we fashioned a new realm and moved there. About 20 years ago, humans stumbled upon it. Humans who knew about Espers and the secret to Magitek power. Thus began a hunt for Espers. Only in this way could Emperor Gestal create his invincible army. In response to this, we erected a doorway and threw the humans out. Even as we speak, many of my kind are trapped in the Empire's Magitek research facility, being drained of their powers. I fled here to avoid a similar fate. That's right, relax. I sensed that Terra was in trouble. My magic summoned her here. Terra's an Esper? No, she's actually quite different. Terra looks like she's in pain. Her very existence strikes fear into her own heart. How can we help her? When she accepts this aspect of herself, I think she'll be all right. We have to do something. Then free those of my kind imprisoned in Gestal's Magitek research facility. One of them can surely help her. If we find the Magitek research facility, You're sure we'll find your people? Magitech Research Facility. Your people are... Like a coward, I escaped leaving the others there. It'll be the end of them. What do you mean? Gestalt's methods are incorrect. You can't drain a live Esper of all its power. It's only when we are reduced to Magicite that our abilities can be transferred in total. Pardon? When we transform to Magicite, our power can be relocated. Magicite? That's what's left of us when we pass away. These are my comrades who fell while escaping the Empire. I will give you my power as well. Old man, are you really gone? Magicite. He traded his power so that others might live. Why are you doing this? We few can help save many. The War of the Magi must not be repeated. Alright, so we've got Magicite now. Ramu, Stray, Kieran, and Siren. So these will actually help all of our party members learn magic. So now everybody's got a set of MP. Depending on who you equip, they will be able to learn certain spells. So if you switch them around, then a lot of people can learn a lot of different spells. Like Ramu, he's an electric-based... Esper, so you give him to any one of the party members. Terra, wait for us. We'll be back. You give him to any one of the party members, then they'll learn their respective magic. Everyone here, I was thinking. Let's talk on the way. The Empire's trying to drain magic from Espers. This can't be true. Celis?
I don't remember because I was asleep when they augmented me. But I've heard rumors to that effect.
Then we're going in. We best split into two groups. We still need to beef up our defenses in Narsh. Indeed.
I'll go to the Empire. I know it well.
But alone? Don't worry, I'll go with her.
Locke?
You need a hand? Alright, so now we can set up our team again. We have to bring Locke and Celis here. So, I'm going to go ahead and let Edgar get his licks in. And, I got to bring Save in. Alright, so we're set. Please wait for us in Narsh. We'll find our way back safely. If you wish to change group members, head for Narsh, which is quite a distance away.
So, how are we going to get there? The Empire's on the continent to the south. No boats go there.
The people of Jador, a town to the south, can probably help us.
Locke?
Yes?
Why are you coming with me?
Well, there's bound to be treasures there. And besides, I've always wanted an inside look at the Empire. Alright, so this ghost will actually teach us how to use Magicite, as I was trying to mention earlier. Got kind of interrupted by the dialogue. So you equip the Esper, you can use it as a summon, and also at the end of every battle, you'll earn magic points. And depending on basically what you have equipped, you'll learn certain set of spells. So if you switch around the Espers, then you can obviously learn a lot of different magic powers. So I'm going to go ahead and get organized here just as an example before we start making our way to the door. First, I'm going to go ahead and heal up. See, unfortunately, I didn't get a chance to heal up while I was in Zozo there. So, I'm going to go ahead and just pass around my Magicite. So, there's four Espers we can use. I'll give Locke Remu, so he'll learn some lightning. Let's see, I'll give Celis. Let's see here. Siren, so she can learn some status ailments and a little bit of fire magic as well. I'll go ahead and give Kieran to Edgar so he can learn some healing magic, and then I'll leave Stray to Sabin so he can learn some other different types of magic. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and call it quits here, and next episode we'll head to Jadora. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.